Yes, viewers, I mentioned it one certain time that the Enugu Onitsha Expressway will be opened this week. Yes, this week is not just the entire expressway, just between Amobia flyover down to the International Building Market, Umuogbo, just to ease up traffic and hold up that day. You know, the vehicles that are meant to carry goods from the market, they are crossing the other side. So, but if you are not, you know, if you are exceeding that market, you are not supposed to use this road. But if you are going to end up in the market, no problems. You can use the road, and mind you that the road is still under construction. The drainage system, they've just started constructing it. You know, like I said earlier, that the drainage system must be there. So they have just started doing it. And if you are using this road, you need to, you know, move on a very low speed so that you don't bring problem to those constructing the road. That is it. So let's go to the site. Now, viewers, we are going to take off from Onitsha. This is the Barak axis. And I know that some people are quite familiar with this axis, but however, you know, we keep getting new people, new subscribers, and the video might get to some other new people, and we thought it wise to start doing some coverage from Onitsha axis. So, and also let's see if there could be some changes from what we have been seeing based on clean environment and you know, road being neat and the rest of them. Also, somebody was saying the other day that I don't used to get the environment as in building and the rest. I said, wow, but that is not a big deal now, that you will be seeing some, you know, the environment of where we are going. Well, this place used to be, you know, very neat when it comes to cleaning the grasses by the left there. But this time around, I don't know what is happening. It's still very, very bushy. You know, I can remember some years past, they used to clean it up. Even inside this roundabout, they used to clean it up. But now, I don't know what is happening. However, let's keep going. So like I was saying, somebody was that is only probably road. I said no, we do capture the environment of where we are going. So this is a good opportunity to look around, you know, to see how the place is looking like. I know that this video is coming across to some people that have not seen it before. So let's keep going. This is Enugu Onitsha Expressway along Mbo axis towards Mbo. We've just passed Boromi roundabout, that's Zix roundabout, moving along the expressway. Yes, we are on top of New Pass flyover, heading towards Tanzan axis. This area is Mpo axis. So after Mpo, we will enter Ogidi. Ogidi is where the building material market is sited along the Enugu-Onitsha Expressway. Yes, this is Ogidi International Building Materials Market. That is where we are now. The market is on the right side there, and we are passing along Enugu-Onitsha Expressway. Yes, from here now we are having a view of Nkwele. Nkwele is Unaka axis. That's the view of Nkwele we are having now. There are lots of estates within that Nkwele. That's why in one of my videos I covered Nkwele, I said it is very, very important that the government should dualize that road from Nkwele, that's from Express here, 33 road, Nkwele road down to 33. By now, government supposed to have done the dualization, but it looks like in Anambra State, individuals are ahead of the government. Government is not catching up with the development coming from individuals at all. So that is the problem. Government should try to catch up a bit with the, you know, individual development that is happening in Anambra State. You know, how can so much estate be there and the road is just one tiny old road? You know, it's not good and it's not encouraging development. That is the point. We are moving along the Enugu Onitsha Expressway. We are heading towards the axis. That's the Omunye axis. Well, it is not out of place if government should make haste to provide truck parks. You know, some of these places that has a natural truck park that trucks used to park along the expressway, which is not good. Government can find a land close by and build park that can still generate revenue for them. You know, government just have to build the park and hand it over to individual. You see, they will handle the billing and every other thing. Well, we keep saying it, and probably the government is you know, trying to do something towards that, but that is the standard. You know, trucks are not allowed to stay on the expressway just like that. It's not done. Some will stay there 2 days, 3 days. Some are even parked there. Probably there is an issue or anything else. Well, that is not good. Then another vehicle can come and run into them. And you know, when they run into them, it's always very serious in terms of an accident. Okay, now observe this place. There is improvement here. They've cut the grasses low, you know, the middle. They've cut it low. It's not like before when it's like tall trees. You know, even if the government wants to plant trees are given at intervals, and they are not allowed to grow so tall. You know, but now you can see you are having a clear view of the other side of the road and. Everything that is happening on that road is always better to have a clear view. This is Odumodu Junction, the place that the accident occurred one time and killed so many people immediately. So now we have entered the area that the RCC just constructed some years back, that is the other side of the expressway, while they are working on the other side. Well, let's keep moving. By the left is the airport, you know, the road that leads to the Chinua Achebe International Airport, Anambra State. By the left there. Well, we are expecting to have a flyover around this place to ease up the movement into and outside the road leading to the airport. From the Enugu-Onitsha Expressway. Well, this is Okuzu. We just entered Okuzu, Anambra State, and we are going to move along Okuzu down towards Ibo axis. Yes, something just occurred to me now. You know, our people, they feel that once road is marked, once they manage to mark the road once, they cannot mark it again. No. The markings on the road can fade. Anytime they fade, they are supposed to be remarked. Yes, that is the standard. The roads at all times should have the markings very, very clear. Okay? So anytime the mark is faded, it should be remarked, like this place now. It's faded now, so it's supposed to be remarked. By the left there is the RCC yard. That's their construction yard, where they have the equipment and everything that they use in the road construction. As we are moving, I observe that the clearing of road has reached Ugbo. Yes, that Ugbo headquarters, it has reached that side. So, but you know, it's just the landscaping as they are walking and be coming down towards that side. Just want to inform you that the landscaping, as in clearing of the road to start, you know, laying the foundation of the road, it has reached Ugbo local government headquarters. Yes. viewers, we just arrived the building materials market at Umuokpu. Yes, by the left there is the building material market, and that is where the road stopped. You cannot move, cannot drive beyond that place. So, but let's turn around to observe the area we are talking about. Viewers, you can observe that that barricade has been removed, signifying that this place is free to be used, so far that you are not exceeding the Building Materials International Market. You can see vehicles coming from the market, you know, towards Amobia flyover to go and turn and continue their movement. Then this is the drainage. You can see that they have started constructing it, and now you can be rest assured that there is gutter there. I used to tell you guys that there is gutter there, that there is no way they will do it without gutter. So it has now been established. Gutter is going to follow there right around the whole road. That is the way they are going to do it. Except if there will be some exceptional places. I know the gutter is going to run round side by side of that road. Well, you know that it's just first asphalt that they've just applied on that road. So the second one, second binder, and the last wearing is yet to come. But before they finish it off, they are going to establish barrier. Those barrier by the left, then they will now seal it up. So this is to show you that the whole place is now motorable. just like we promised and just like we have been doing. We'll keep giving you updates, you know, when it comes to projects that you need to be updated, and that is what we do. We have just done this one, and we are hoping to bring subsequent ones to you. And that is it. We are still moving along Enugu-Onitsha Expressway, moving towards Bata Unizik Junction. Probably we are going to terminate our journey somewhere there. Well, you can see the present look of this place.